A completely stock 2.0 EcoBoost will dyno about 230 wheel horsepower in most applications, and so the modifications on this list will get us to about 300 wheel horsepower and somewhere in the 340 to 350 wheel torque range. Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're talking about performance modifications and upgrades for Ford's 2.0 inline four EcoBoost engine. Now the 2.0 EcoBoost is a turbocharged engine, and so while a small 2-liter inline four doesn't sound like it might be the most powerful engine, there are actually a ton of power gains that we can get from just a couple basic bolt-on modifications. So in this video, we're gonna talk about five basic bolt-on modifications that can add about 70 to 80 wheel horsepower on the 2.0 EcoBoost engine. The 2.0 EcoBoost has been used on a number of Ford and Lincoln vehicles from 2012 all the way up until the present. And of course, there are a few different variations of it. There was a variation used from 2012 to 2018. And then in 2015, they came out with a twin scroll turbocharged version of it. But all this to say, both of these engines are going to have the same modification list. There are some technical changes, but from a power potential and a power capacity standpoint, both of them are relatively similar. So regardless of what vehicle you have, this will be applicable to you. A good thing about the 2.0 EcoBoost to start with is most of the vehicles that it was used in have around 250 horsepower and about 270 torque. There are a couple models that have a little bit less horsepower than that, and there are a few that have a little bit more, but the good news is the engines and all of them are the same. The only difference is the tuning. The engines that have lower horsepower levels are still able to make the same amount of power as the ones that start with higher horsepower because we are gonna change the tuning, of course, with one of these bolt-on modifications that we talk about. A completely stock 2.0 EcoBoost will dyno about 230 wheel horsepower in most applications, and so the modifications on this list will get us to about 300 wheel horsepower and somewhere in the 340 to 350 wheel torque range. From a performance potential or a power capacity standpoint, once we get to about 300 wheel horsepower is when you're gonna have to start looking into some more advanced modifications to get power out of these engines. Most specifically, you're gonna have to upgrade the fueling, and you're also gonna have to upgrade the turbocharger because 300 wheel horsepower is just about the max capacity for the factory stock turbocharger. So after these basic bolt-on modifications, you're gonna need to start looking into some more advanced and expensive modifications, but those will soon push you very close or even past the safe power limits of the 2.0 EcoBoost, which are approximately 400 wheel horsepower. But at the 400 wheel horsepower level, you really have to have your tuning dialed in properly because you are at risk of blowing a motor at any point at that 400 wheel horsepower power level. So realistically, the safe limits of this engine are probably more like 350 wheel horsepower. And of course, to go ahead and up that from 400 to 500, we're talking about having to crack into the engine and do a lot more serious internal upgrades. So for the most part, sticking with these basic bolt-on modifications, getting 70 to 80 wheel horsepower and making about 300 wheel horsepower out of the 2.0 EcoBoost is pretty close to as good as it gets unless you're trying to do a very serious build. With all that being said, let's go ahead now and jump into the list of modifications. First on the list, we have tuning. Tuning is where all of your big power gains are gonna come from. Your gains are gonna come from turning up the boost pressures on the turbocharger, and that is gonna lead to about 50 to 70 wheel horsepower power gains, and so that's gonna be where a huge chunk of the gains come from. The rest of the modifications on this list, while they will add additional horsepower, they're more so to help support the tuning and to make your engine run more healthily when modified and when running higher boost levels. Number two is gonna be a cold air intake. Whenever you're tuned on a turbocharged engine, it's important to bring more air into the engine to help feed the turbocharger and reduce the amount of stress that's being put on it. Now, from an intake, you're probably gonna get anywhere from 3 to 10 wheel horsepower out of it. The 3 wheel horsepower is going to be probably on the lower end if you have a completely stock engine. You'll likely see closer to the 10 wheel horsepower when you combine it with tuning, but ultimately you will get good gains from an intake, and it's also extremely important from a reliability standpoint just to help bring more air into the engine and help support the higher boost pressures coming from the turbocharger. So once we have tuning and an intake, the third modification on this list is going to be an upgraded downpipe. We're now bringing more air into the engine, the turbocharger's operating at higher boost pressures, and we now have more air that we have to then get out of the engine. The issue with the factory downpipe is that it houses the catalytic converter, and it sits directly bolted up against the turbocharger, and so it creates a lot of what's called exhaust back pressure. That back pressure acts as a force against the turbocharger, and so it actually slows down the spool from the turbocharger, which puts more stress on the turbocharger. It creates more heat within your exhaust system and within your engine, and therefore it also can steal power because your turbocharger might not be able to hit those higher boost pressures as easily. So by upgrading the downpipe, we can reduce a lot of the back pressure within the exhaust system, which is going to lower your engine temperatures and your exhaust gas temperatures, which is going to give you a lot better reliability, and it's going to free up turbo spool, which is what's going to give you the good power gains. A downpipe when tuned is good for about 10 to 15 wheel horsepower and about 15 to 20 wheel torque. And of course, here you have the option of going with a catted or a catless option. The catless option is going to reduce back pressure the most and have the biggest performance impact, but it is also not legal from an emissions standpoint. And it might also be difficult to find different variations of this depending on what vehicle you have with the 2.0 EcoBoost in it, just since there is a little bit more limited aftermarket support for various vehicles. So those are our three kind of super simple recommended bolt-on modifications. The fourth thing on the list here is going to be an upgraded intercooler. An upgraded intercooler is probably going to offer the least from an actual power gain standpoint, but it's going to offer the most from a performance improvement standpoint. And that's because the factory intercooler on the 2.0 EcoBoost is very small. It's not very good. It doesn't have a whole lot of airflow, and so it's not great at cooling the air that's actually going into your engine. So an upgraded intercooler will help you lower your intake air temperatures, which therefore is going to result in some small power gains. But the biggest thing that it's going to do is it's going to give you more consistent performance, and your engine won't be suffering from heat soak, which can actually rob you of 10 to 20 wheel horsepower. It's a great reliability mod because we're cooling down the air and sending cooler air into the engine, which helps lower our engine temperatures. And then fifth on this list is going to be ethanol fueling, or E85. The factory 2.0 EcoBoosts can't handle 100% E85. To hit 100% E85, you will need fueling upgrades, but they can run on E30 blends, and with an E30 blend and proper tuning for it, you can get about 10 to 15 wheel horsepower out of just running a blend of E85 and traditional gasoline. This is a great modification because ultimately it's free. All you have to do is go fill up and put a couple gallons of E85 into your gas tank. You just need to make sure you have the proper tuning to be running an E30 blend. But ultimately, it's a free upgrade that can add a lot of power. And if you do get to the point where you're trying to push beyond 300 wheel horsepower, it's definitely good to look into some of those fueling upgrades to be able to run 100% E85, because there will be really big performance and power gains if you're able to do those upgrades and run full E85. Anyways, guys, that covers it for our five modifications. As I mentioned, all of those will get you somewhere around the 70 to 80 wheel horsepower mark and put you in the 300 wheel horsepower ballpark. Again, just to recap, pushing beyond 300 wheel horsepower, we're gonna need to look into fueling upgrades and turbocharger upgrades. Ultimately, 300 wheel horsepower is a good, safe limit for these engines. One thing that I would say is if you're a little bit more hesitant on the modification side of things, once we start talking about downpipes, intercoolers, those are relatively expensive and slightly more difficult modifications. Just about anyone can install an intake by themselves and also install some plug and play tuners by themselves. So if you're just looking to add a little bit of extra power and make your car more fun, I think you'd be very surprised what just adding a tune and a cold air intake would do for it. My recommendation, if you're on the fence, is just to go ahead and go for tuning and an intake and see where you're at and see how happy you are from there. But if you want to maximize your power gains and your reliability, you're going to want to do a downpipe, an intercooler, and E85 fueling or an E30 blend. But of course, the 2.0 EcoBoost was used on a number of different vehicles, and the aftermarket support is a little bit more limited for some of the less performance-oriented vehicles out there. And so you'll just have to do some searching around to see which of these modifications are available for your car. Anyways, guys, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all the future content we have coming on Ford's EcoBoost engines.